Let's make a form. I'm going to create a new file. I'm going to call it a search attempts, PHP. And I'm going to say, I'm going to skip with the, I'm just going to say search attempts. H1, it's going to put a nice header at the top, and then I'm going to say first name. Input name equals first name. And I'm going to put a last name. Input name equals last name. And I'm going to put address. And then I'm going to have a submit button. Say search on it. And I need, this is a form. Form. Action equals, and I'm going to go, and I'm going to modify this display attempts. I'm going to modify this program to be able to accept this thing. So I'm going to do that. And you recall, I can make it where the name value pairs are part of the URL, and that would be the get method of submitting forms. Or I can make it where the name value pairs that go in, the search criteria, go in as a packet and don't appear in the URL, and that's a better way to do it generally. So I'm going to do method equals post. And then I'm going to end the form. Okay, so that's a perfectly good form, and you can type in a first name, a last name, an address, and you can click search. Now, we haven't at all defined what it's going to do with that first name, last name, and address and coming in, or whether or not they're optional or not, or whether you have to type in the whole first name or just part of the first name or all that. That's going to be handled when we construct the select statement from this data coming in. So first of all, I'm going to save this, and I'm going to go to it. It's this thing here, search attempt. So when I click there, this thing comes up, it's our search form. Now it doesn't matter what I type. When I hit search, it doesn't do anything, it just displays everything. So what I need to do is make it so when you enter something in here, it somehow affects the select statement here. This is the select statement. And it somehow adds to the where part of the select statement to narrow down the search. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a space there. And I'm going to add SQL. Concatenate. I just split that select statement into two parts, and inside here I'm going to put a where. So first of all, I got to have data. I have to process the data coming in. I should probably process it at the top. I think I will. So again, we got a first name coming in. Okay. First name equals request. And we have the same thing for last name and address. And so that's coming in. I'm not going to bother with the apostrophes. Now, So I'm going to build up this where, because I don't know if there's anything there. There may be something there, or there might not be anything there. So I'm going to create a new variable called where, and I'm going to start out where it's not equal, where it's empty, and I'm going to say if first name is greater than nothing, then I'm going to append something onto where. I'm going to do where is appended on. I'm going to say it's whatever it is, and because I'm going to append, I don't know what's going to, how many of these are going to be, and first name, and okay, I'm going to say that they don't have to type in the whole first name. They just have to type in the first part of the first name, okay? And so I'll do it. I say like, and like me, okay. Like means you can use wildcards. And I'm going to do, it's going to be first name. And then I'm going to put a wildcard there. And what that wildcard does is that wildcard can be no characters or any characters. So if I'm searching for rich and I type in rich, I'll get it. But if I'm searching for rich and I type in RI, I'll also get it. I'll also get everything else that starts with RI. So this is what I'm going to append onto that where for that. And I'm going to do the same thing for last name and address. And so I'm going to do last name here. And for address, I'm going to do something even fancier. I'm going to say that I'm just going to type in some portion of the address, some string that's someplace in, somewhere in the address, or not, or I could type in the whole address. So I'm going to put a wildcard on both sides there. And so that's my where. And so I've constructed my where. And so now, if there's a where, then I gotta append it into the SQL right here. So SQL equals, and if there's a where, there's gonna be that additional and in front of it. Two ways I can handle that. I can do, I have to have the where, and there's two ways I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it the way I like it better, and that is I'm gonna concatenate substring of the where starting after the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the sixth. I'm going to hack off the first, no, five. I'm going to hack off the first five. So that'll work. Append the word where followed by like this or something. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to someplace, okay, so that's that, it's going to execute. I'm going to, just so I know what's going on here, I'm going to echo out our SQL statement just so I can see what it looks like. All right. So what I've done is now this display page will look to see if there's any request name value pairs coming in, namely of these three. If there is, it's gonna assume that that's parameters for a select, for the select, and it, oh geez, I gotta fix this. This should be that. This should be that. So anyway, let's try it. Okay, so I'm going to search for rich. And I get all the riches. Nice. How about if I search for, well, first I'm going to search for nobody. Oh, it's not displaying that. Did I not save this? Echo. Oh, I forgot the... This. Okay, so this is my SQL statement. You notice there's no where there because I didn't have any. But if I go rich, then look at the SQL statement, and it's got this, where first name is like rich, and you see just the riches. Let me see what, you know what I'm going to do, since it's, I'm going to add a clear input type equals reset value equals clear. So now I can clear it. I want to see them all. Okay, I'm going to search for I'll search for try searching for Moku. Moku. And see, it's that. And if I do more than one, let me search for Joe Halverson. Halverson. There it is. JH. So that's okay. Now I got time. So I'm gonna put a search attempts. Yes, it is. Okay, now I have a new search link down here. All right, now let's say I want to let's say I want to search for within a date range, within a date time range. Okay, so that looks, you know, you need to, your search form needs to look a little bit different. So you can do time how can we do this? Input name equals GT time. I'm going to call it GT time. Time. It's less than or equal to. So I'm going to do less than or equal to. I need to do this. LT semicolon for less than equal to time. Less than or equal to. See what this looks like. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a lower value and an upper value for time. And so this is how you do a greater. This is how you do a less than. To make a less than in HTML, you need to do ampersand LT semicolon. You got to remember the semicolon. Okay, you got to remember the semicolon. Ampersand LT semicolon, and then followed by an equal sign would be less than or equal to. And so basically, what there's going to be a value coming across called GT underscore time, and I want time to be greater than or equal to. I can, if I want, I can name these greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. It's got to be great. Time has got to be greater than or equal to this value, and it's got to be less than or equal to this value. And I can also make it where that's only if these values are there. They might not be there. So these are two more values that are gonna come across: GE time and LE time. So I'm gonna do add those here. I'm gonna call it GE time and LE time. And so then right over here, it's going to add that to the where. And what I'll do is put a couple more there. And if GE time is greater than something, then I'm going to do where A time, is that what it's called, A time, is... greater than or equal to GE time. Now, we'll see how this works, because we're going to be typing in a time, and we're going to have to see how robust the MySQL database management system or database engine is in figuring out exactly what we're asking for. For right now, though, I'm going to do this. There's other things we can do to fix it up. And so just let's do this for now, though. LE time. And so I'm going to do A time is less than or equal to LE time. Yeah, I'm going to just see what this does. Okay, so I'm going to do, what kind of times are we talking about? We got, it's all today. I'm going to do this for the upper time. I'm going to do this for the upper time, and I'm going to do 43 for the lower time. So it's going to be within this range. I'm going to get within this range. The 53 and the 43. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this. And I'll put the upper range is this, and the lower range is 43. I'm going to just do this. Now I'm just, I haven't tried this earlier, so I'm going to see what this does. Yeah, it worked. Very cool. Okay, I have 12 minutes. I have 2 minutes left. I'm going to show you a trick here in PHP. Let's say that let's do this. I'm going to add some more code here. I'm going to say A time equals no, not A time. I'm going to do it up here. I'm going to say if GE time is greater than nothing, then I'm going to make GE time equal date y-m-d space h.i.s. That's MySQL time format. Just happen to know that. And I'm going to do strto time GE time. And I'll do the same thing for LE time. So what strto time does is you can type in anything that looks like it could be translated to a time, and then it actually converts it to that. Now I don't know if we have enough data in there to actually try this out, but I'm going to go, it's all going to be today, I suppose. Nine o'clock. 10 o'clock. I don't know. Let's see what happens. Okay, 9 o'clock worked. But 10 o'clock didn't work. Or maybe 10 o'clock did work. Oh, neither of them worked. Did I mess something up? Oh, this LE10. Okay, so this isn't really a very good example, but if you do today, yesterday, no, it'd be yesterday, no, today, yesterday, we get, you know, this is yesterday, and this is today, I guess, time. So I guess this isn't really a very good example, but what happens if I type this in? It should still work. And it does.